Good afternoon. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us today. We're going to get started with our dancers, Tejas Dance. They're going to be right here to my right, which is your left. Please point your attention to Tejas Dallas.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. I hope you all can hear me very well. Good afternoon again. Thank you very much to our performers who just opened our Dallas Arts Month 2024 kickoff press conference. The performers go by the name Tay Jazz Dance, and they just performed a classical form of dance originating from southern India. Before I start my remarks, I want to invite anyone who may need Spanish language interpretation to the information desk in the back. We have translation services and interpretation services available back there. All right, good afternoon. I'm so excited to be here. I'm Martine Philippe, I'm the director of the Office of Arts and Culture, and April is the month that we get to shine, Dallas Arts Month. I want to first start by acknowledging some of our elected officials and appointed officials. We have some visitors as well. So let me begin with first greeting Mayor Pro Tem Atkins, Deputy Mayor Pro Tem Carolyn King Arnold, Council Members Resendez, Narvaez, Blackman, Schultz, and Ridley. And I saw that Ms. Willis is also with us. Thank you so much for being here. I'd like to, of course, thank you for your service. Oh, and Mr. Moreno, who is speaking with us. Forgive me, Councilman Moreno. I'd like to also recognize Deputy City Manager Tolbert, who is joining us this afternoon, and Assistant City Manager Liz Cedillo-Perea. Thank you both for your steadfast support of the cultural arts sector and initiatives here in the city of Dallas. I'm really excited to be here with you all today to celebrate our 11th annual Dallas Arts Month, which started as a week and now it's a full month. We're gathering community collectively to participate in many arts and cultural programming offerings found across this city of Dallas. So like this morning, you'll see many different practices, forms, displays of art that can be found in every corner of Dallas, including our City Hall lobby wall. We have featured artists here on display in conjunction with our Art 214 exhibition that's happening across our cultural arts centers. Bathhouse Cultural Center, South Dallas Cultural Center, the Latino Cultural Center, and Oak Cliff Cultural Center. And there might be some art up at the Moody too, huh? I believe so. Please be sure to visit throughout the month of April. In collaboration with external stakeholders, many which of here, let's see, raise your hand if you consider yourself one of our stakeholders. Some of our arts organizations that are in the house today, some of our artists who are in receipt of support from our office. Thank you for taking the time to join us as well. We're here to amplify the work you're doing, and we thank you for your creative contributions to the fabric of the community here in Dallas. So again, in collaboration with our stakeholders, many of which are here today, we're excited to share that you can find our calendar of events on dallasartsmonth.com. So if you happen to know of an event that we are not yet aware of, feel free to email our office and we will include your event. We want to ensure that folks have access, residents and visitors, access to easily find programming and know where to go to have a great time. Before I close my remarks, I want to share one more note that I'm equally excited to discuss, which many of you may be aware that April is not only Dallas Arts Month here, but is also Autism Acceptance Month. And so for the first time this year for Dallas Arts Month, we'll be launching a landing page that lists sensory-friendly programming for families who would be interested in engaging. We want to make sure we have arts are for everybody. So we invite you, thank you, we invite you to acknowledge and celebrate World Autism Awareness Day on April 2nd. And once that landing page is available, please, engage with some of those sensory-friendly activities. Again, it's really important to me to ensure that we mean what we say when we say arts are for everybody. One last note, I'd like to acknowledge our Arts and Culture Advisory Commission members who are present, Chair Small, Commissioner Meek, Commissioner Daniel, Commissioner Best, Commissioner Nugent. Anyone I overlooked, please forgive me. Commissioner Curiel, my favorite folks, thank you for holding us accountable. Thank you for your advice. Thank you for your guidance in ensuring that, especially this Dallas Arts Month, our commissioners backed us up and ensured that we not only diversified the planning committee, but that we paid more attention to intentionally caring about the types of offerings that we're elevating and amplifying on our platform. So thank y'all. Now, in closing, thank you to all of the city officials and our commissioners who are here. for the work that you do to support the arts ecosystem. I also want to thank the staff of the Office of Arts and Culture who are also here. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Many of you know we've had a busy week. We had a significant public art unveiling and dedication ceremony yesterday, installation here in the City Hall lobby. Folks who know it's budget planning week, and we have been very busy, and I'd be remiss if I didn't acknowledge the time and effort you all are putting in to not only make this city a more beautiful place, but to make it more welcoming. And I'm so grateful to be getting to work with y'all. Okay. Now, it is my pleasure to welcome to the podium our Dallas Poet Laureate, outgoing Dallas Poet Laureate, Joaquin Zihuatanejo. Oh, yes, thank you. Please welcome to the podium. I'm so glad you're here.
Thank you. My two-year term as your inaugural Dallas Poet Laureate is up in 17 days. So I hope that over the course of April, you incorporate poetry into your programs. Just don't ask me, ask the next Poet Laureate. I want to thank the Office of Arts and Culture for the City of Dallas. I want to thank the City of Dallas. I want to thank the Dallas Public Library, who has treated me like family for the last 2 years. I also want to thank the tip of the spear, Will Evans and Deep Vellum Books, for making this post possible for me and for the future poet laureates to come. One of the biggest prizes attached to this was a new book deal from Deep Vellum Books, and my book came out 2 weeks ago, and it's out and ready to go out in the world. And since I was a teacher so long ago that the state of Texas gave me, seriously, on the bottom of my certificate, when it says expiration date, it says lifetime, which means I can give homework till I die. So here's your homework, Dallas. Buy this book from Deep Vellum Books. Tell everyone you love, tell everyone you hate to buy it. Thank you. I'm gonna read a poem for y'all and then get out of your way. And when I became Dallas Poet Laureate 2 years ago, they asked me to write a poem to accompany the accommodations release. And I wrote this then, and I thought, what better way to close out my 2 year term at City Hall than with this? So this is called For a Place Called Dallas. There is no real reason for a place called Dallas. From a political flyer promoting a major bond issue in Dallas, 1985, as cited in the accommodation by Jim Schutz. Let us do more than simply move beyond the past, let us learn from it. Let us change both in spite and because of it. For so long we've been reaping what we sow, knowing what we know all along, that smoke fades while terror tends to linger. I've been trying to put my finger on this place called Dallas for a while now. How people love to simplify. That whole beautiful shining city of the southern sun belt reeks of black ties and white lies. Dallas is much more diverse and conflicted and beautiful than that. It's hoop dreams at an inner city by inner city youth. It's Jim Schutz telling an awful truth in a poignant and necessary way. It's Will Evans publishing a book written 36 years ago today. It's a Southside single mom working two jobs to make ends meet. It's loving someone this way and never letting go. It's waking up to laugh with Jubb Jr. and Gordo. Dallas is more than just a place, it's a state of mind. It's the community council moving families forward, leaving poverty behind. It's breathing free, at least it should be. Walking city streets, never feeling restricted. It's Mark Melton fighting for the unjustly evicted. It's a non-binary black poet reminding every queer person in this city that you are a snowflake, born to be the most beautiful thing you can be, yourself. It's me, at age 19, peering through Parkland pediatric glass to catch a glimpse of my newborn daughter. It's Robert Walonski and Sara Gardoña honoring their fathers with what they create, with how they live. It's Word Space and Karen X and all that she selflessly gives. It's Sylvia Komatsu devoting herself to public media every single day, the 40 plus years of service and heart she poured into KERA. It's Joe Goodice guiding us in all things library, equity, and design. It's Anita Nanez Martinez reminding us that Ballet Folklorico is divine. It's Pleasant Grove Highland Hills, 10th Street, Freedmanstown. It's a journeyman creating safe space down a diverse lounge that's shutting down the small town country club oligarchy with its stones and sticks, its urban politics. Closing the door and speaking soft-spoken truths betrays this city's youth. Believe me when I say they are desperate to know where they come from. Let's make it our duty to teach our children their history in all its ugliness, in all its beauty. What if equality, fairness, and generosity was what we sow? What if we do something revolutionary like take some of the funding set aside for the Ross Perot and give it to black and brown-owned theaters to help them grow, to show them that this city, our city, sees them. So let us confront the truth in topic lyrics reverberating through UTD and SMU dorm halls. Let Daniel Yanez paint it in murals on West Side walls. It's equal parts Stevie Ray Vaughan and Bach. It's Jess Garland teaching girls how to rock. It's a city finding a way to not only acknowledge but support the activists, artists, and advocates that make this city extraordinary. But after all this, they still say there is no real reason for a place called Dallas. And I say, everyone gathered here today is reason enough. Dallas is a place where wellness begins. It's the momentous institute building social-emotional health in our youth. It's Vicky Meek in the South Dallas Cultural Center teaching young people to find the artist that lives within. It's Aspire teaching refugee mothers and fathers and children. It's Artitude supporting queer artists who paint and write towards catharsis. It's the Austin Street Center lifting up those in need. It's the Senior Source helping the bereaved. These are among the many reasons for a place called Dallas. It's me. It's you. It's Sonny Brine's barbecue. It's my abuelo whispering to me in Old East Dallas, tu voz es tu poder. Words I will never forget. It's a young, poor, brown barrio boy becoming this city's first ever Dallas Poet Laureate. It's always fighting the just and good fight. It's a street poet from Oak Cliff righting wrongs with all its might. It's everything we've been through and all the good we will do. So let it begin with you. You. Me, we, you, me, we are the reason for this place called Dallas. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Joaquin. Thank you. Next, to help kick off our event, we will have Deputy Mayor Pro Tem Carolyn King Arnold read the proclamation recognizing Dallas Arts Month.
Thank you. I know you didn't have enough energy for clapping after that performance. So we appreciate it. We are here today to celebrate. As stated, I want to just be very quick because we do have a 1 o'clock time of returning to the horseshoe. Yes, this month, as you said, I'm happy to see, of course, the arts and the arts family. And I failed yesterday at the event at the county with Martyrs Park to recognize the work of the arts department. And so, Ms. Martine, I want to make sure I recognize you for your work. I recognize staff, but I did not recognize my art commissioner, Mr. Jesse Hornbuckle. I know he's not here today, but he does an awful lot of work on behalf of this city and, of course, this district. So I did want to correct that so that I would not hurt any feelings. And sometimes we do that, and we don't really know that we have done that. And so with that, I have been asked to issue the proclamation. And most of you know the visual behind a proclamation and the artistic features that go into a proclamation. Am I correct? The first artistic feature would be that of whereas. So we're going to ask Ms. Joanna Santangelo, would you please come up to receive the proclamation? It comes from the office of the mayor, and I am not really an artist, but I do know how to glean, and so I'm going to glean from this proclamation. So we know the whereas. The main points that we want to ask and acknowledge today is that the Dallas Arts Month is a grassroots initiative. It celebrates and shines a spotlight on our city's dynamic arts scene and aims to foster learning, which is creative, activity, as well throughout this city. Art is an integral part of our city's character and soul. Artists and cultural organizations of all sizes play a very vital role in weaving together that constitute Dallas as a cultural ecosystem. And whereas the arts have strengthened the Dallas economic vitality and has promoted innovation by attracting businesses and welcoming artists, performers, and other creative thinkers to our city. And that's according to the Texas Cultural Art Trust. Thank you, I've kind of lost my track here just for a moment. Dallas, of course, is rated the number one best arts district in the 2024 U.S. Today Reader's Choice Awards. And so we continue to boast of the museums and award-winning performances and renowned urban art centers. And so whereas the arts continues to support the standard of living in Dallas by offering residents and visitors the opportunity to learn, create, and participate in a wide array of impactful and authentic cultural experiences. As Dallas continues to grow, it attracts art lovers from across the city, the state, and nation. And as a destination site that embraces all types of artistic mediums that continues to contribute to our city's thriving art scene. So now, therefore, as we move through this program and through the month, we want to continue to encourage residents and visitors to experience the many artistic and cultural programs, activities, and events happening across the city of Dallas. So now, on behalf of Mayor Eric Johnson, and of course, the illustrious Dallas City Council, you want to wave? Come on, we have to let them know we're in the house and that we support the arts. We do declare today, the month of April 2024, as Dallas Arts Month. And so we thank you for allowing us to even be here as a part of this event today. But we do know this is not a part of the proclamation, and most of you know that I do go off script. And that's why they didn't hire me to be at Hollywood movies. I can't follow the script. But I want you to know that all of you out here, we know arts is a heart, but you have council members here today that you need to recognize and thank for their actions to support the arts. So I'm gonna ask that you recognize our council members. Would you please stand? Come on, council members, we're not gonna be shamed. And so, I don't know if they, and you know I have to change, we're gonna move on because I have to go eat. Council members. Because we are the ones who have to make that decision. And so sometimes, you know, you just have to give credit where credit is due. Now, they didn't pay me to do this. They're not promising me any votes. But I do know you need each one of the council members to support us, to support. And see, you know, Councilmember Gay Willis, nice, she's not shy. So can y'all come up right quick so we can take a quick picture of us right quick so we're going to lunch. Do y'all mind? Thank you. Come on, stand up. We're not gonna be shame, are we? We voted to support this. Just take a quick picture of us.
Arts commissioners, come here. Arts commissioners, real fast.
Thank you, Deputy Mayor Pro Tem. Before our council members break, we do have several who will be speaking. I'm going to call out the few and then introduce the first. We'll be hearing remarks from Councilmember Jesse Moreno of District 2. We'll be hearing from Councilmember Paul Ridley of District 14. And then we'll be hearing from Councilmember Janie Schultz of District 11. But first, I'm really pleased to introduce the Honorable Councilmember Omar Narvaez of District 6. If you don't know, he is a staunch and steadfast advocate for the arts. Can I share about your award?
Sure, sure.
So, you might see this beautiful handcrafted award that the councilman is carrying with him today, and I'm happy to share that Councilman Narvaez received the annual Leadership Award presented from Americans for the Arts and the National League of Cities. He's the second council member to receive this award, and the award acknowledges the councilman's efforts in ensuring that the arts have a place to thrive, and it really speaks volumes about your commitment, if I can say this to your face, speaks volumes about your commitment to ensuring that we increase equitable access to the arts. I'm really grateful to share space with you. All right. These are mine. Who has... Somebody took his stuff.
So who took my talking points? Does anybody have another copy of my talking points? Because I had them and now they're gone. Thank you. This is why you don't let council members do artistic stuff and try to do impromptu art, you know. So anyway, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Omar Narvaez. I'm the council member for District 6 here in the city of Dallas. And I've been an art advocate since I was probably about this big, not even realizing what it was that I was advocating or why I was advocating. And I want to thank Martine for discussing and about this award. I knew about this award growing up, and I knew it was a very prestigious award. Folks like President Bill Clinton, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, many other just very prominent artists like Gloria Estefan have been given this award. And when my name was nominated by Lily Weiss and Joanna St. Angelo, wherever you are, please wave. I was like, oh, cool, like this is really cool to even be nominated. You know, like they say about the Oscars, like, oh, it's just a privilege to be all nominated, but you're never gonna win it. Cause I'm like, come on, it's President Bill Clinton, Nancy Speaker Pelosi, like, and then somebody like me. And I didn't think of it more than that, except for what an honor to even be thought of. And then when it was announced like 3 or 4 weeks later, I honestly thought it was done and over. And then the Americans for the Arts sent a letter saying, congratulations, you are the recipient. It was one of those things where it's like, whoa, like this is like even bigger than I thought, to be the second city council member in its history to receive this award. And it's handcrafted, it's done, you know, it's something so unique. And I received it last year in, I think, October, when I got to go pick it up at NLC, National League of Cities, in Atlanta. Now, I was given strict guidelines on how to carry it, and you can see me, I continue to hold it the exact same way. And then, I mean, look at this thing, and I wanted to bring it down so that you all could also see it, because not everybody has ever seen one of these in person, and much less own one, you know what I mean? And, So it's not a candy jar by any means. It's in my office, prominently displayed amongst my baby Yodas, because that's the other big deal that, you know, big deal thing to me. And I can say that thank you, Lily and Joanna, and all the other arts people like Chris Heinbaugh, and just keep going down the list. My commissioner, Damani, man, you've kicked some booty, I'll say the right word, out there and bringing equity to the arts. And the whole point of this, like Arts Month, is to make sure that all of our communities are brought together, whether it's fighting for dollars. We always know we need the dollars, right? And I know that my colleague, Councilmember Willis, and I are very proud to have really fought hard and championed for the bond election that's coming up. And somebody, I think his name is Chris Heinbaugh, came up with this idea of 6%, 6% of the bond. And it just resonated, and I think she and I know the rest of my colleagues, I can't discount a single one of them, that 6% of the bond should go to the arts, to go to our facilities and fix them and repair them. And it made it. It made it into the bond. I can't tell you how to vote for the bond because we're in a city facility, but what I can tell you is we're sending to the voters of the over $1 billion bond, that 75 million of it is to go to the arts. And that those dollars, yeah, please, this is the largest. This is the largest investment in Dallas history from a bond to the arts. The largest investment in Dallas history to the arts. And that is something that we should be excited about and something that we should make sure that we remember when that election comes up. What I can tell you though is seeing you all here today is a great reminder and showing of how important the arts are and how they're thriving. You heard earlier about Dallas being named in 2024 the best arts city in the nation. We're also named the best sports city in the nation. We've also been named that we have the best large airport in the nation, the best medium-sized airport in the nation. We're just the best because we're the city of Dallas. And you know, there's this joke that goes around the state of Texas called Dallitude, right? Yeah, you've heard it, Dallitude, Dallas attitude. And you know, I grew up being told that, you know, that I'm no better than anyone else. And it's true. And that we're not snobs, we're not snobby people, we're not. But when you are better than everybody else, it's just the gospel truth. And it's not being snobby, it's just, look at all those awards that we've been given. But what I can tell you is that during the pandemic, we had some really tough years. A couple of really tough years. We lost a lot of really good people. And we lost a lot of the trajectory that we were going into. And what I can tell you is that during that pandemic, it was one group, one set of people, one entity that really saved us. Because we didn't know how to have government meetings anymore. We didn't know how to put things together. We didn't know how to talk to each other. But there was one group, and that's the arts community. The arts community showed us how to have Zoom meetings. The arts community started to produce things on camera. They started to give us things like Hamilton for free on our TV sets. They showed us how to do the little things like drag queens performing in order to make their dollars and their coins in order to continue their art. And I can tell you that if it wasn't for the arts community, the city of Dallas, the way we do our meetings, we would not have been able to get there. So thank you, arts community, because without you, government would have stopped and the people who needed the help most would not have received it. And that's a big thanks to you all. Now, I'm going to be quick because I know that I can take a, if you met me, I'm not one to be shy of words and I can talk a lot. But what I'll tell you is that I'm proud to share that my neighbors and I now have access to more arts, to more culture across not just our homes and together and all over the place through this city. We're not going to build giant Moody theater centers in far west Dallas. There's no space, there's nowhere to build it. But what I can tell you is through partnerships, we've been able to get arts and culture out into different parts of our city that have never seen them or witnessed them, whether it's Symphony in the Park, whether it's making sure that we teach dance lessons in far west Dallas to moms, single moms and children who, Chris, that changed to something completely different than we expected it to, because people continue to want to do it, and they changed the program, what they needed, what they wanted. And I can tell you that during Ice Storm Uri, it was the arts folks that I reached out to, because this guy tends to, my favorite event during the holidays is the Light Your Night at Reliant Energy does down in the Arts District. And I remembered that they gave us these little red flashlight type thingies that get turned on by charging. And I called Chris Heinbaum in the middle of an ice storm where nobody was moving ever to go around. And I was like, Chris, do you happen to have any more of those little swag light up thingy majingies left over? And he said, you know what, let me look. There might be something left in a closet. And it was the arts community that showed up and brought like 75 little lights to West Dallas so that our neighbors that had no lighting could be able to get some type of a light through solar and got them on so that we could get people, just senior citizens, being able to see how to get to the bathroom in their own home. And that's thanks to the arts community. So when it comes to the arts, it's a lot more than just entertaining us, making us think, making us politically challenged on what we're gonna do. Sometimes it's just literally helping your neighbor out in their time of need. And I'm gonna close this with the same way that I closed it at National League of Cities, which is to my mom. Gracias a mi mamá. She didn't always understand me. She didn't always get me. And I think even today, people don't always understand me and they don't always get me. But what I can tell you is that the drama nerd and the band Geek is making things happen in this city. Gracias a todos. Thank you very much. Happy Arts Month.
Wow, I love the energy in this room. Thank you all for joining us today. Joaquin, gracias por los años. That hit close to home, and it was very inspiring as a fellow Woodrow graduate myself, and as a kid from the barrio of East Dallas. As a council member for District 2, I'm excited to share the celebration today with so many supporters and leaders in the art communities. I might not be an artist myself, but I do have a 6-year-old at home who hopefully one day will be able to see her artwork displayed somewhere here in the city of Dallas. In our very own District 2, we regularly celebrate the vibrancy of the multicultural heritage through art, whether it be on a beautiful mural in Deep Ellum, the magnificent statues in downtown Dallas, or the architecture marvels. Art reminds us of our past and how it can inspire us for the future. Just yesterday, we had the honor of unveiling the shadow lines in District 2. The world can be a difficult and scary place at times, yet even in the darkest moments, it is artists like the ones I see here today that bring hope in bad times and inspiration in good times. Later this month, Madam City Manager, I hope you're hearing, I'll be traveling to Atlanta to look at the Beltline Cultural Trail. And I hope that we can bring something similar to Dallas in the near future. With that, happy Dallas Arts Month.
Good afternoon. I'm Paul Ridley, and I have the honor of representing District 14, which includes the Arts District. I'm honored to be here today to celebrate Arts Month 2024. As a longtime supporter of the arts and participant in the lively arts scene in Dallas, I want to discuss the importance of having space for artists to work, live, and thrive in Dallas. Within District 14, which includes downtown Dallas and the Dallas Arts District. Just a few weeks ago, USA Today, as you have heard, named the Dallas Arts District the best arts district in the USA. There are many iconic locations that can be found here that visitors from across the country and the world seek to visit. But it would not have been possible without the hard work of Dallas arts leaders nurturing the area and making this district the heart of arts in downtown and the city. The 2018 Dallas Cultural Plan made space one of the top priorities citywide for artists and organizations. With recognition of being named the best arts district in the nation, we must continue to make space available and accessible to the artists across Dallas that make our city vibrant and a place that people want to not only visit, but build their lives. We must provide, create, and incentivize the creation of spaces and places to encourage the arts and culture in Dallas to thrive and grow. Thank you all for being here today to celebrate as a community the great arts ecosystem of Dallas.
Hi, everybody. I'm Janie Schultz, and I'm the council member for District 11, North Dallas. As we gather here to celebrate the exhilarating kickoff of Dallas Arts Month, I'm thrilled to share this moment of joy and anticipation with each of you. Dallas, as we all know, stands as the ninth largest city within one of the fastest growing regions in the nation. This is a clear testament to our ever-expanding horizons. However, what makes our city truly great and stand out is not its significant size, but its heart, as Omar mentioned, as Paul mentioned, as Jesse mentioned. The growth we've experienced transcends mere numbers. It's about building a community that welcomes everyone with open arms, whether they're new neighbors or visitors from afar. It's within this collective drive for inclusiveness and unity that District 11 proudly hosts the newly designated Dallas International District and the Esperanza area, home to the incredible Goldmark Cultural Center, which is home to over 170 artists. Thank you, Joseph Wave, so that everybody can come and talk to you afterwards about the Goldmark Center. But the Dallas International District is not just another urban development project. It's a once-in-a-generation lifetime opportunity to unite and amplify our growing global community, as we saw with our dancers today. The International District is set to be a beacon of Dallas's global leadership as a vibrant, multicultural live, work, play, visit community that celebrates, encourages, and inspires diverse people and businesses across North Texas. As our city continues to grow, it is crucial that we remain committed to ensuring that everyone, including those who've called Dallas home for generations, feel prioritized and heard. This commitment to inclusivity is embodied in the Prism Center, located right in the heart of the International District. This innovative space not only serves as an international business and community center, featuring international trade offices to foster global exchange, but it also has space for cultural and artistic expression. Right now, we have an exhibit of the history, the African American history of North Dallas. The Prism Center has also played host to night markets with all kinds of programming. There's even a reggae festival that's going to be held at the International District April 12th to 14th. So as we embark on Dallas Arts Month, let's embrace this opportunity to showcase the artistic and creative and cultural wealth of our city. Let's support our artists, let's visit galleries, let's participate, let's get everyone signed up for the Cultural Arts Pass and immerse ourselves in the beauty of art that comes to all of our lives. Thank you for being here today. Appreciate it.
Thank you very, very, very much for those remarks. All of our council members highlighted tenets of our city's cultural plan: elevating multicultural heritage, increasing spaces for artists, and of course, ensuring that the city of Dallas is a more welcoming place. We're talking about Dallas Arts Month, and I just wanted to pause and quickly acknowledge that it's still Women's History Month. And our next speaker is making history. Our next interim city manager is here to share some remarks. So I'm so, so, so pleased to welcome you, Ms. Kim Tolbert. Thank you for being here.
Well, thank you very much, and good afternoon to everyone. So I'm going to start with a confession. I walked in and I saw all this beautiful art, so I have decided as I was sitting there that it's time to redecorate the city manager's office. So I'm going to delegate to Liz the responsibility of getting all this beautiful art moved down the hall where I'm going to be effective June 4th. Can y'all clap for that? Good afternoon. I'm so happy to be here, and I'm excited to serve this city as one of our deputy city managers. And it is such a wonderful opportunity to be able to stand here with so many friends and so many individuals that I know make art in Dallas happen. So you all actually deserve a round of applause. So I'm making this special announcement, but before I can get to the announcement, they asked for me to give you some brief remarks about the Cultural Pass Dallas and what this program really is. And we know that it has been an amazing addition to our city starting in 2019. But the program is really designed to provide Dallas residents with a library card access to arts and cultural programming for free. Let me say that again, for free throughout the city. It supports Dallas area artists and organizations who utilize the program as a means to reach more audiences and promote individual programming. Starting in the fall of 2019, it was placed temporarily on hold during the COVID-19 pandemic, and we've had more than 40 partners commit to the program, offering various attractions for our library cardholders to choose from. These partners make up cultural centers, performance venues, film groups, museum, theater groups, independent artists. So it's a wonderful collaboration for the city of Dallas. And so we are very grateful today. We're very blessed today to have so many partners bring that level of generosity to help us keep Cultural Past Dallas alive. So I'm delighted to share with all of you today that when the program will become available to you again, you'll need to reserve your tickets to attend many of the attractions, but the Cultural Past Dallas will debut to Dallas library card holders beginning Saturday, April the 20th. We want to make absolutely sure that you spread the word. Make sure that you visit culturalpassdallas.com, where you'll be able to find the full list of all of the participating organizations, and there's also a list of frequently asked questions that you'll be able to review, and you'll know exactly what to do. And so the energy again in this room is, it's overwhelming, because we truly understand that without arts, we cannot have the quality of life in our city that our residents deserve. So thank you all so very much for what you do. Thank you for joining us today. And please get out there and let's explore together. Again, thank you very much.
Thank you, DCM Tolbert. Now, you see, we are right here in City Hall lobby. You can see the library, okay? If you need to walk across that street and get yourself registered, we invite you to today. Leave here, go to Dallas Public Library, and sign up for an enhanced library card if you haven't already. The enhanced library card is a bit different from the typical one. It contains your name and your picture, and that may be used as a supplement with other documents to prove your identity. And I also want to shout out my peer director, Joe, who's here, Director of Libraries, thank you. And my other peers are also here. I'd be remiss if I didn't acknowledge Dr. Wilson, Director of the Office of Equity and Inclusion, and I saw Director Evans of OEQS. Thank y'all for being here to support the team. I'm really grateful to serve with y'all. So, we're going to close soon. We have closing remarks and a closing performance. One note for me is that you'll note we have two dance performances today. Many of you might not know I'm a retired dancer, and we'll be closing Dallas Arts Month by celebrating International Dance Day right back here in City Hall Lobby on April 29th. So please come dance with us. It's just really important to me that we elevate all forms of dance, so each year we'll try and focus on one discipline and bring that forward for your consumption. Now, to close us out as it relates to remarks, we'll be inviting Miss Joanna St. Angelo to the table. Thank you for being such a fierce advocate for us. I'm so grateful for you.
Thank you, Martine. And I want to thank our city council members, our assistant city managers, our cultural affairs commissioners, and especially the staff over at Office of Arts and Culture, because I know you had to work, do a lot of extra work to get this done today. And all of our hardworking city staff members. So let's give them a little round of applause. So 11 years, this is our 11th year for Dallas Arts Month. We started very, very modestly with a week of just a few events and had no idea that it was gonna turn into this. So this is amazing. And we've all been through a lot in these 11 years. Thankfully, we are all recovering. The arts are better than ever. We're back. We have even more diversity than before, but it has been a difficult few years to recover from pandemic and all of the other impacts that we've had. So one of the things I wanted to share with you today is the outcome of the Americans for the Arts Arts Economic Impact Study that we did in 2022. We wanted to make sure we actually had the data to prove how important the arts are to our community. So I wanted to share a little bit of that information with you. We have almost 14,000 jobs that we can attribute directly to the arts activity just in our city of Dallas. Local tax revenue was more than $20 million. Total tax revenue for local, state, and federal was almost $170 million. More than 6.8 million people attended arts events in Dallas in 2022. The average amount that was spent for each one of those attendees was $47. And for the first time, there was a qualitative assessment added to the other data collection to actually find out how people really thought about the arts. And what we found was that almost 90% of people attending arts events place a very high value on the cultural assets in our community and agree that our venues and artists are an important pillar in our community, and they would feel a great sense of loss if they were not available. We did all of this together, and since 2022, we've been doing even more. And we know that with your help and support and continuing to work together, we're going to even do more in the future and make Dallas an even better and more vibrant place to live. By working collectively, we are all stronger. Your work is so important. And the other thing that's important is your vote. Your vote is your voice. And there is an important election on May 6th. And we want to make sure you are all registered and that you're prepared to vote and that you're going to try and get everybody else out to vote. It means a lot, not just to the arts, but to every person in Dallas. So I wanted to make sure you are aware of that and that we have your support to move all of these important issues forward. Just to close, I want to thank you all for being here today. This is a wonderful turnout. I think this is the most people we've ever had for the kickoff. And I just want to thank you all for being here. And then the other thing I want to do is introduce a wonderful, talented group of dancers from one of my very favorite groups here in Dallas. We're going to be entertained by the Anita N. Martinez Ballet Folklorico. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.